Hi, Representative John Bradford here with my legislative coordinator, Matthew Schwab. Just want to give you a legislative video update. Senate Bill 105, which is the Senate's version of the budget, has now arrived over to the House. That means for the next few weeks, the House will be working on making any changes to the budget before we then send it back to the Senate for an up or down vote. And if they don't agree, which chances are they will not, then we'll go to a conference and work out our differences, and then the budget will move along through the process to the governor for his consideration. Now, I'm one of the senior chairs for finance, so that means my role is to work on our tax policy for the state. And I'm here to tell you that I always believe in putting more money back in your pockets because you can spend it better than the government can. So we will make tax cuts with the policies that we're going to put in place. I can't really share any details with you yet because we're still working on those, but that is the goal. A few other things, House Bill 366, which was our first regulatory reform bill, has made its way to the Senate. It's going to the Senate floor soon, so I expect that to get a passing vote. And so hopefully the governor will sign that, and that just shows that we continue to do regulatory reform work in North Carolina, which is a great thing. And then Matthew is going to share some good news.
Yes, good news indeed, John. I'm talking about the good news of House Bill 642. Is a bill that will prohibit organ transplant and discrimination for Down syndrome and other intellectual and developmental disabilities persons. And very excited to announce that this bill passed the Senate and the House favorably, and right now is sitting on the desk of Governor Cooper, hopefully waiting for a signature and implementation of the law.
So this is very exciting. We expect the governor to sign this bill, and it's a wonderful piece of legislation. So happy to do that. Another few updates for you. House Bill 83, the House has passed this. It has gone to the Senate. This would eliminate income tax for our military retirees in North Carolina. The bill, you know, is still going through the journey, meaning it's out of the House, and now it's over in the Senate. So we'll see what they do. The House has also passed Senate Bill 116 called Putting North Carolina Back to Work. The Senate also passed it, and now it's over to the governor's office. And what this means is this would withdraw North Carolina from that $300 federal benefit, which is close to expiring anyway, but it would also strengthen the requirements for people who are on unemployment to actually go out and try to move the ball ahead and find a job. If you're going to be on unemployment, I understand that, but you need to be out looking for a job so you can get off unemployment. And this would strengthen the requirements for that. And it would also create a $250 million block grant to help with childcare for people that have children and need help so they can go back to work. And then also, the House has passed a bill called Free the Smiles. It's now over at the Senate, but this would make sure that the state could not require masks for all schools. It would be left to independent school districts to make those decisions. We feel that should be a local decision, not a statewide decision. And again, this is now over in the Senate, and we got to see what they do, but the House has passed it.
And we're excited to announce that all of you in District 98 and other counties in the proud state of North Carolina can spend July 4th fishing. And those who already have a license, you can do it, but those without a license, you guys can join with the others that have a license, and you guys can also fish for free on July 4th.
It's a free day to fish. In North Carolina, we waive the licensure requirement. This year, it's on 4th of July. So get out, have a hot dog, throw a line in, see if you can catch some fish, all for free from the good folks here in North Carolina. And because it is 4th of July, we'd be remiss not to wish you a very happy 4th of July. Celebrate friends, family. Think about all those that have made sure that our country keeps its independence and our freedoms, and be safe, of course. And lastly, should people come visit us or what?
Yes, they should visit us.
Come on up and see us. We'd love to give you a tour of the chamber, the committee rooms. Capitol's still not open to the public yet, but trust me, Matthew's a great tour guide. So am I, and we'd love to host you. All you gotta do is reach out to our office, and we'd schedule it to the best that we can. Tuesdays and Wednesdays are typically good days while we're here. So anyway, have a great day. We'll see you around the district. Thanks for listening. And that's a wrap, right, Matthew?
Yes.
Good job.